On behalf of SME Chamber of India, SME Technology Development Council and Federation of Indian SME Association, jointly with the Amazon Internet Services, it's my immense pleasure to welcome you all at this important and very useful webinar. Rather, this is an interactive webinar, and today we have a stalwart from different sector, particularly from the SMB management's division, Mr. Harshad Satam, who is in a field sales head for the AWS for the Amazon Internet Services Private Limited for the Indian SAARC. So Harshad ji, welcome at this very important webinar. We have a very stalwart person, Dr. Rajendra Jagtale. He is the Director General and CEO of Science and Technology Park, which is initiated by and promoted by the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. And he's also one of our National Advisory Board member and also the member of SME Technology Development Council, who is going to speak on the role of government in IT technology development or upgradation in SME sector. Rajendra ji, welcome at this webinar.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
So, friends from the different sector, from the industry, SME sector, also I invite to request you to give a focus and your attention on what we are going to present today, which is very useful for you because internet services is most important. Without internet services, you cannot use any smart business solutions, or not even you can use any other further activity. Offline, always people are working, but online is the most important. Since we know that AWS is one of the topmost AWS is one of the world's most topmost comprehensive and the broadly cloud platform offering internet services and more than 200 fully featured services from the data centers globally, and which is one of the useful for services currently, not only just buying product from the Amazon, but you can use a lot of products. And also I observed that so many smart business solutions. The smart business solution, which is useful for the SME sector. The SME sector, those are looking to transform, develop, expand, and continuity for the business activity, offline, online, or even working from home, doing business from home, or doing business from office. Friends, importance of the technology in small business, very, very interesting, because without technology, SME will not grow. Without technology, any industry will not grow. Technology development is most important thing for each and every businesses. We know we are in a industrial automation. We are now in the fourth revolution of the industrial automation, and mostly the revolution done in the technology part, that is the most important. Technology enables us to work every minute of every day from any place on the planet. This is a thin line we have taken, and which is useful for the each and every person. Technology and business, it's a collaboration. Unless until we will not use any technology for particular productivity, services, or any type of business activity, we need a technology. And mostly I observe that most of the SME sector, they are looking advanced technology, but they are not understanding which technology can be adopted and which technology can be useful for my business. But therefore, we have collaborated today AWS for exchanging, informing, and exhibiting the product and services which is useful for the SME sector. I'm sure that today's webinar will give you insight, ideas, and what are the uses and benefits of this product or the platform which will be useful. Similarly, we know that the Digital India initiative taken by the Honorable Prime Minister. So we have taken the initiative of a digital SME platform. So digital SME platform, which is bringing the stakeholders from industry, from technology, from digitalization, and they are providing platform to SME sector. Why? Because we want to empower SMEs for global competitiveness. SMEs should adopt technology, SME should adopt affordable technology, and SME should adopt patented technology. That is our main motto. And therefore, this webinar, informative webinar will be useful for you, but particularly, enhancing your connectivity. How the in your business research is most important, developing customer communication is most important, marketing skill is very, very important. Of course, productivity, without quality productivity, you will not achieve any target. mobility is there, you know, security is also, because most of the companies are facing problem where the security point of view, cyber attack is there, cyber security is there, and mostly so many SMEs or industries losing data. On our stalwart from the industry, Mukesh Ambani always says that, you know, data is a fuel of future. So data is better than costly than gold and, you know, platinum and, you know, diamonds. So data is most important. So how we can save, secure our data, that is the most important. For that purpose, you need a quality technology and, you know, knowledgeable technology. So there are plenty of, you know, the platforms are there for particular marketing, promotion, branding, promote productivity, particularly, you know, the we are looking that, you know, so many SMEs are looking for, you know, development of their manufacturing industry. This corona has taught so many things to us. Because of the corona, we started working from home, we started understanding the new technology. So similarly, what are the product, what are the facility, and what are the benefits of the any particular technology? So we have to, you know, hear from Mr. Satam on the today's this program. So I think this is the right time to invite Harshad Satam ji to explain, exhibit, and, you know, inform our entrepreneurs that what kind of technology AWS is presenting, what is a new idea, new unique concepts or new techniques are AWS is presenting, particularly for the benefit of the SME sector. So I request Harshadji to give your thoughts on exclusive product offering from Amazon Digital Superpower by AWS for a SME perspective. With this words, I'm thankful to AWS for joining hands through the today's event. And I'm sure that this will be useful for the SME sector. I'm sure that Dr. Jagdali will also share his thoughts. So again, I welcome all of you, and I request Mr. Harshad Satam to take a lead for a further battle. Thank you.
Okay, thank you for the introduction, and I really appreciate you sharing that perspective. Thank you, Mr. Jagdale, for participating in this conversation with us. So I'm fortunate that we have industry people from the industry, and we have so many entrepreneurs who have joined this forum. So I'm going to keep the messaging pretty simple, right? And let me share my screen. So like Mr. Salunke said, right, this is often a question that a lot of young business folks, SME companies ask us, right? How do I choose what is the right technology for us, right? And can you talk to me in very simple terms? You know, seedhi bhasha mein batao ki how do I choose the right technology? It should not be very complicated, right? Then second is, you know, how do we talk to you, right? How do we engage with you, right? If you have the right technology, how do we engage with you in this regard? And third is, you know, how do I take my first step? Where do I start? What is the starting point? So this is the 3-point agenda that I'm going to briefly cover, and I will try to keep technology away from the conversation because that usually, you know, confuses a lot of people. So I'm going to keep the messaging very simple. So let me start with a simple poll, actually, right? Let's start with the poll. And all of you, a lot of participants are business owners, right? So if I have to ask you, and you can type it in the chat window as well, right? What are your key business needs? Top of the mind, right? Don't think too much and start, you know, sharing some feedback with us on chat. You know, some of you. Let's wait for like 10-15 seconds for this, right? If someone comes and asks you, what are your business needs? What are your business priorities? Top one or two, what would you say? I'm just trying to see if I can see the chat. Okay, we see we have a shy group, so let me get started. Funding and technology. Thanks, Sandeep. Okay, funding is a key need. Technology is a key business need. What else? Do we have any other participants? Security. Okay, I'm saying that, you know, you can keep technology aside. Generally, you can speak about what are your business needs. Market research, okay? Market research, so that you know which are the new sectors, areas, customer segments that you go after. Marketing, okay, good. And when I say marketing, it probably means getting new customers. Data management, Nilesh. global reach. Thank you. Good. Okay. So we've also had this conversation with a lot of customers, right? And some of the things that we heard from these customers were four things, right? I want to bucket this into four things. We want to grow, right? Very simple. We want to grow our business. And when I say grow, I want to get new customers. I want to go after new customers, new geographies. I want to launch new products, right? Everything that is related to growth. The second thing they wanted to say is that when I grow, I also want to simplify my operations, right? If I have taken X amount of effort to onboard, let's say, Y customers, I shouldn't be spending proportional effort if I keep on increasing, or if I do 2Y customers or 5Y customers, right? Okay. Third thing is we want to optimize, right? We want to do more with less. That is the simple meaning of optimize, right? And the fourth thing is we want to differentiate, right? We don't want to be one of the business that does what other 10 businesses also do. So that can we differentiate ourselves, right? So grow, simplify, optimize, and differentiate, right? Very simple messaging. And I'm going to speak that, you know, if you have to grow, how can technology help you, right? Discover new customers, go digitally to new customers. That is something that I will cover. How can I simplify, right? You have a offline business also, you can't let that go, right? Just because Harshad tells you to do that. You will have an online business, you will have an offline business. How do you manage both of those? How do you optimize your operations? How can you do more business with the same amount of people by driving more productivity, efficiency? And how can you be a, how can you differentiate your product or business in the market, right? By using some of the modern technology. So this is what, this is the area, the below row is where Amazon and our partners can help you. And this is something that I'm going to speak about in the next few minutes. Okay, another poll, right? Let's say, right, which of the following, right, and you can put all your options in the chat window. Once it comes to technology, first question was around business. Second is, let's say you have to go and start using technology. Which of these four you feel is what you face often? Difficult to access, too expensive, difficult to understand, lack of support. Lack of support. Nilay says lack of support. Ganesh says too expensive. Completely understand. Eric says difficult to understand. Absolutely right. Thank you so much, right? Thank you so much. Because this is what customers have told us, right? That, you know, for you, you know, Amazon, it might be easier to talk in terms of technology, but for us as SME businesses, right? Sometimes technology is too difficult to understand. And when we want to adopt it, we realize that it's exorbitantly expensive. It is not meant for SMEs. Third thing is we can't access it. We don't know where to go and access. We can't pick up the phone, speak to anybody. Where is it that can I just buy it like the way I buy things on Amazon.in, right? You put it in your cart and you buy it, right? That's an easy way to go and buy things. You can't buy a lot of technology like that. And the fourth thing is, presuming that I buy it, I don't know how to use it, right? Is there anyone who will come support me, tell me how to get started, right? So these are the four challenges that we face very often, and customers tell that this is something that you should be solving. Okay, we also spoke to a lot of customers, and like I mentioned, right, 84% of the customers said that accessibility is an issue. We don't know from where can I get technology. It is not as easy as buying things on Amazon. 82%, right, said that if we choose to buy something, it is exorbitantly expensive. All the technology is meant for enterprises. It is not specifically meant for SMEs, right? 81% said it's too complex. Business people can't understand it, right? It is full of technical jargons, too many things to be done. And like 74% of the survey that we did, they said that support is not available. We don't know whom to call. We don't know who can guide us, right? And let me tell you, right, what we are seeing in India, and not just today, right, for the last few years also, this problem is being addressed by an ecosystem, right? And we are point number four, actually. We are technology companies, right? But if you look at SMB associations, like this forum that Mr. Salunke runs, right, industry association, government bodies are all coming together to help SMEs, because SMEs drive the growth for the country, right? And if this is such a big problem for SMEs, right, we should all come and try to solve it. And I think this webinar is one of the steps in that direction, to simplify it, make it more accessible, make it more affordable, and it should be easy for you to get started. I'm just going to talk about what are we trying to offer, right? If you look at all the four stages, right, grow, simplify, optimize, and differentiate, we as Amazon Web Services have partnered with companies who have built their solutions on top of our cloud computing platform, right? And these solutions actually offer you ready-made technology solutions at each stage. For example, right, let's say if you want to run your own e-commerce website, right? You want to build a small e-commerce website, you're going to publish your products, that Amazon actually offers you a service around that. Vinculum actually provides you omni-channel. You have an offline model, you have an online model, and you want to manage between both of these, right? So that will give you like a omni-channel retail automation solution. If you want to have basic accounting, right, Vyapar can be a good financial ledger or basic accounting software that you can get started, right? And Razorpay can actually manage your digital payments. And if you see that if you're at the grow phase, right, you're starting your business, you want to get started with adoption of digital technologies, these solutions are the ones for you. If you're at the simplify stage, right, then we go a step further, right? Vyapar will provide accounting, Vinculum will provide omni-channel experience. But let's say you want to have a CRM in place, right? You want to have chat support for your customers. You want to have someone to look at your customer conversations. How do you respond to customer queries? Freshworks provides a platform around that, right? You want to take care of your employees, because in simplify stage, you are now probably a bigger business. You will have more number of employees, and you need to take care of your employees. You want to have payroll. You want to have employee management, and you would need a HR solution like GrayHR. Next stage is, if you're a larger business, right, and if you want to actually have all some of this accounting, you want to have an office suite, you want to have inventory management, you want to manage websites also all in one, right, then you look at a solution like Optimize stage from Zoho. And the fourth stage is, right, is where I and my team work with, right? So this is really where you differentiate, right? You are trying to use analytics to target new customers, to create new products, right? You are building your own e-commerce business completely independently, right? And these are the kind of services that AWS provides, and I and my team provides. Now, why that comes last, right? So if what we provide comes in the differentiate phase, but we realize that you as SMEs, right, require ready-made solutions in the earlier phases also. And that's where we and our partners like Vyapar, Vinculum, Freshdesk, GrayHR, Zoho have created ready-made solutions depending on which stage you are in, right? So it's not very complicated, easy to use. And if you want to take care of your taxation, GST, invoicing, right, then ClearTax is a solution that is also available. It's a partner of AWS. And irrespective of what stage you are in, you will probably benefit from that as well. So for the sake of this discussion, right, we've tried to focus on two pillars, simplify and optimize. And we are going to focus on a couple of solutions around, let's say, employee management and inventory and accounting from Zoho. So the important thing that I wanted to tell you is that, right, these are not very complicated solutions from our partners. These are not really big solutions. They are not expensive. And these are being used by SMEs like you, right? And we have a couple of SMEs that have already adopted the solution, and you can look at the kind of feedback that they are also getting, right? very easy to adopt, can get started very quickly, right? And it can do all the things that you expect in an employee life cycle, right? Employee management, leave, payroll, look at employee feedback, streamline operations, right? Everything falls into place. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to run a small video for you, right? It tells you how the product looks like, and then we will move to Zoho.
Hi, I'm Dinesh, and I welcome you on a journey to experience great HR. And great HR, it's our constant endeavor to innovate and design HR and payroll solutions for our customers like you. So let me start with a short tour of our application. As soon as you log in into the application, you can see there are some specially designed tools which will help you to understand the application better. From employees, you can see an overview of all the employee information that you have, the newly joined employees, the upcoming holidays, employees who have confirmation due, the employees who have resigned. You can manage all your employee information from here. From admin, you can generate letter. You can post news and updates to all your employees via bulletin board. Also, you can send emails and SMSs to a group of employees or to all employees by using our mass communication feature. As soon as you land into the payroll, you can see payroll information of the current month. You can lock or unlock the payroll inputs, or you can release the ID statement employee view. From here, you can process the payroll. From the information, you can see the salary revision history and the analytics. From payroll inputs, you can manage your employee salary, salary revisions, loans, reimbursements. You can process the payroll and then get it verified using a quick salary statement or a payroll statement. And finally, you can generate accounting vouchers and bank transfer statements to pay salary to your employees. Once payroll processing and payout is done, you can publish payslips to all your employees from here. Now let's go to leave and attendance. So, from leave calendar, you can see the leave information of your employees in a calendar view. In who's in feature, you can see the real-time attendance of your employees. From information, you can get all the employee leave information, see the employee real-time swipes, and get attendance information of all your employees. Not only this, we have something called as reports, which has 100 plus ready-made reports developed statewide to help you comply to state and central regulations. These will save you from hassles and make your life easier. Hope you liked a small demonstration of our great HR application. Now, let's get started.
So that was about great HR, right? And I see a question around, let's say you want to report something around your employees, if you have to align certain compliance, right? It's like a click of a button. And that's where we've chosen such solutions like this to address the needs of SMEs, right? Another solution is Zoho, right? A very popular solution. If you want to do inventory tracking, warehouse management, order management, multi-channel selling, right? Then Zoho is a solution that offers all these features. We also have SMEs and a couple of testimonials over here from FIDA India, SPC Healthcare, right? So these are also, they're not very large organization, SMEs in their own ways, and how they have looked at Zoho as a platform, got good support, right? And seem to find a good value out of these solutions. Let's run a quick video on Zoho so we can also get a look and feel of the way we got for Grey HR.
Zoho Inventory is built for modern businesses to easily manage orders and inventory. With Zoho Inventory, you can manage your customers and vendors, keep track of your inventory, create sales orders and purchase orders, get paid online, and fulfill orders efficiently. The dashboard gives you an overview of your business doing. You can find your best sellers, products that are running low on stock, your sales activity across different channels. You can manage your vendors and customers here in the contact section. Find the recent shipments and fulfilled orders and credit history of a single contact at a glance. This is where you house all the products that you carry. You can either import your items in a CSV format, or you can create all the items from the scratch. You can add the purchase price, selling price, and available products and SKUs. Also, keep your inventory organized by creating variants of an item. You can create a sales order easily by entering the customer's details, delivery method, and the items that the customer ordered. Manage your orders from different channels across each stage of the fulfillment process. By that, you will know which one needs immediate attention. You can find the invoices associated with the sales order right here. Create purchase orders to manage incoming goods. You can receive an order in parts and keep track of all the receivables. Convert them to bills and make your payments to your vendors. You can connect your account with Zoho apps like Zoho Books and Zoho CRM. Services like Amazon, Shopify, and over 25 shipping services are integrated, and you can configure them right here. This creates an end-to-end solution that streamlines your entire business operations and saves you a lot of time and effort. With powerful reports, get actionable data and make better decisions. You can view the key takeaways and download them as PDF or Excelis. You can use the search bar to search any data in Zoho inventory. Click on this question mark icon to find our help documents. To contact support, click on contact support and type in your question and send it across to us. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, you can.
Thanks. The other thing that we've done is, which is equally important, is that, right, we've tried to address the accessibility challenge, the affordability challenge that was there, simplicity and support. And we've actually created an Amazon digital suit, right? And these were just some of the products that I mentioned. The digital suit actually has more products, right? I spoke about Zoho, I spoke about GrayHR, Winkelung, ClearTax. There are more products available on the Amazon digital suite, because what we are trying to do is look at the ecosystem, get these products together. A lot of these run on the AWS cloud platform itself that provides the security, availability, technology backbone that is needed to run such applications, and made it to, and it is like buying solution or buying stuff on Amazon retail, right? You go, add it to your cart and start using it. We've tried to give a similar experience when you come to the Amazon digital suite. So you effectively buy technology like you would buy any other product. So for people of this webinar, right, we are actually got good offers from our partners, GrayHR and Zoho. The inventory module that was mentioned is actually available for free. You can just scan this QR code. Right. If you're not able to scan now, don't worry. Reach out to the SME Chamber team and they will give you the QR code. For GrayHR also, you can actually start using it for free by just scanning this QR code. For the rest of the solutions, there are very good starting offers for Razorpay, Vyapar, ClearTax, Freshworks, right? And you can scan this as well, right? And you can get started. So this is something that, you know, will ease the first step. So this is how it works, right? We have Association Member of India who has scan your QR code and redeem the solution, right? Activate the code, and then if you need support, our partners will reach out to you to help you activate the solution in your business, right? So that also works perfectly. I think Q&A we're going to take later. So I would hand it over to Dr. Jagdale after me.
Yes, thank you, Ashok. Very well presented. And this is rather very interesting, because most of the SMEs are not aware, you know, where to contact, how to contact. So we have three questions come out. Then I will get back to you after Dr. Jagdale's talk. Dr. Jagdale.
I'm very glad that I'm hearing you today. We have a network of more than 100 incubators. I'm founder of Incubator Association India called ISBA. And AWS has been our partner, and each one of us have been given adequate licenses free of cost for the use of startups that we promote. Thanks for your support. And Chandrakantji, let me assure you, AWS support would be great support for SMEs who cannot develop their own product for their own management, both for in-house management and external support. And AWS is a very good platform, and we have experience of using it. People are very happy. I'm very happy to see that there are more than 90 people have joined this meeting. And this gives me an opportunity to connect our SMEs to what we do. Let me very briefly tell you what Science and Technology Park is. We are an organization promoted by Government of India, Minister of Science and Technology, as one of the Science and Technology Entrepreneurs Park. And of course, apart from promoting entrepreneurship, technology entrepreneurship, we do a lot of other support in terms of policy support to the government, both Government of India and to the states. We also do a lot of technology management services for academia, research institutions, and some of the industries that will come to us in terms of helping them to patent search, apply for patenting both within India and outside. Then also advising them correctly whether whatever the invention they have, whether it needs to be patented or just needs to be published. Because many people, just for sake of getting patents granted, they apply for patent and get patent, and we block the research. And so I would say I have been a scientist, I have been a professor on the University of Pune campus for many years. 90% of our patents are for sake of patents. 10% probably are worth considering for commercialization. That needs to be changed. But I interact very closely with SMEs within Pune region, and I can tell you that huge amount of research that happens within SME sector, which is neither patented, but it is having a great potential for patenting. And that's one area that we can support. There are government programs to support this. I will not focus on Ministry of SME, MSME, because there are a large number of schemes. I'm sure that SME Chamber will do that. There's a scheme for energy efficiency. There's a scheme for designing your product jointly with NID. SME Ministry has been running that scheme. I was initially involved in that. And so they give huge support for mentoring SMEs for designing their product. And you know that many times we come up with a product which are functionally very good, but look and feel wise, appeal wise, they may not be very appealing. And we may not be able to get market comfortably because design is not proper, even though functionally they're good. So there is a design clinic services by the government. A lot of mentoring happens through NID. We also do that. There's a scheme for Aspire program is there, which up to 15 lakh rupees, you get a grant in aid to develop your product. So there is a credit linked capital subsidy for technology upgradation for SMEs. I think 15% of the investment that you do up to 1 crore for upgradation of technology gets back to your subsidy. So there is entrepreneurial management development through incubation program is there, that's operated through incubators network like us. So any SMEs require incubation support, we are there to give this. And of course, there is a program for IPR and technology management support. These are the programs run by, operated by Minister of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprise. I will not focus and go into details of those. Let me focus on what we do. We have been running three programs, and through our network, they are available to SMEs across India. So there's not only for Pune region. if somebody wants to be a very, I would say, micro entrepreneur, he wants to start his own business and does not have funding to start a business and does not have money to sustain himself or herself, we run a program called EIR, Entrepreneur in Residence. And a large number of fellowships are awarded for young entrepreneurs who want to start their own small micro enterprise. And about 30,000 to 35,000 rupees per month is a fellowship is awarded. And frankly, Chandra Gandhi, we do not get very good response through the chamber. We would like to reach out to right audience so that right kind of people actually get take benefit of this. Limit of fellowship is no limit. We have we can raise any amount of funding to support such entrepreneurs. Objective of this is to that at the end of this tenure of maybe 1 year maximum, one has to come up with a fundable business plan. All the mentoring to come to this stage has been provided free of cost. The space is provided within our incubators free of cost. So that's a great support that we can take, especially for micro enterprises. Then somebody from SME sector or from incubation community or startup community, if they have any idea and they need money to convert their idea into a working prototype and which is ready for pilot testing. So there's a scheme to support up to 10 to 15 lakhs of rupees as a grant. It's a 100% grant. No liabilities for repayment. So large number of such programs, projects can be funded. Then after that, we also operate one program, which is seed fund program under National Initiative for Development and Harnessing Innovations. It's a program. Under that, we have seed program. Especially, we support up to 1 crore rupees against either debt, equity, or there's a ratio of debt and equity that's discussed with the startup. And this program, we also can raise higher amount of money if that's required. We have funded up to even 5 crore rupees. And in our and next level of program, we have an accelerator program. There's no limit of funding. We have funded up to even 5 million rupees, $5 million dollars. So about 30-35 crore rupees funding is possible. So so far we have supported about 150 plus companies physically within our physical space, and more virtually probably we must have supported more than 1,600-1,700 companies. So all this, I will request SME chamber to make this available information to various sectors. Especially we have been sector agnostics, but over the years we have emerged into few sectors, especially agricultural equipment. It is especially spraying, dusting, applications of drone, harvesting, food processing, electrical vehicles, 100% made in India without importing anything from any country. We have technology basket to develop EVs, electrical vehicles, and also retrofit vehicles. We have already developed technologies which are AR, AI tested. For example, we can convert your old gypsy, petrol gypsy, Maruti gypsy, into electrical gypsy in 4 hours, just 4 hours. So right from that, we have now developed electrical boats. There are millions of fishing boats operated by our fishermen. They spend nearly 3.5 to 4 lakh rupees every month on diesel. And it's easy to convert those into electrical boats, which will not only save our seas from pollution, but also take home for our friends working in the fishing industry will be benefited. We are also into medical equipment and diagnostics, especially DNA-based diagnostics. we have several companies in that domain. Waste management, I see there's enormous potential for waste management. If you consider waste as a resource, it is unfortunate and very shameful to see that though even those cities like Pune, Mumbai, New Bombay, Delhi, Hyderabad, Agra, why not? All these major cities, there's no dearth of money, but we have not solved the problem of solid waste. There are very easy solutions available, and those are financially viable. If some of the SMEs want to take this as their business, we don't mind sharing technology basket with them and support them with initial funding, and also help them to get a government contract in the beginning till they become on their own. So I see that's a huge potential. I just give an example. We in Pune, we are at the moment manufacturing nearly about 50,000 liters of diesel from plastic and thermocoal, waste plastic and thermocoal, which goes for landfill because it's not recyclable. Terminal plastic, which goes for landfill. And we are manufacturing diesel. This not only diesel, there are large number of other products can be done from this. From using agricultural waste, at the moment, by September, mid-September, we'll be manufacturing 60,000 liters of diesel, not biodiesel, it's a diesel as per diesel standards. And this is zero sulfur diesel, far better than the diesel that you buy on petrol pumps. So 60,000 liters, 70,000 liters is the peanuts, which is not even fraction of requirement of diesel demand that we have, we are not able to meet. Somebody wants to venture in this, the kind of raw material that we have in India, we can manufacture up to 25 crores of liters of diesel per day. That's the raw material we have. We do not have to import crude oil. We do not have to spend foreign exchange for importing this. All this is there. It can be done by as a small SME enterprise at a district level, at taluka level, and produce diesel locally and supply to the local population. So there are some of the areas that we have been working. I also want to make an appeal to our SME chamber members. And under our ministry, there's a DSIR, Department of Scientific and Industrial Research. Many SMEs do a lot of product development, they do a lot of research, but they do not register as a research center. If please go to DSIR, it's not very difficult, it's very easy. Register yourself with DSIR, all your expenses that you spend for doing research is exempt from tax. You get a huge amount of import duty if you are importing any equipment for research. And once you have done something, if you want to patent it, there's another scheme for patenting it, up to 30 lakhs of rupees. I'm sorry, 30,000 rupees to 35,000 rupees is given as a grant for patenting within India. And even if needs to be patented overseas, then there's a funding available for overseas patent. Even though there are restrictions on funding, but one can explore that opportunity also. So all these areas, we also work with about 28 countries, Science and Technology Park. We have set up something called India Welcome Centers Abroad. I have India Welcome Center, 9 centers in Europe, 23 centers in Asia Pacific region. And through those centers, any SME wants to explore business opportunities in those countries, they can go with their product or their technology. 6 months to 1 year, office facility is given free of cost. There's no charge. At many locations, we have also tied up with an accommodation, well-furnished single bedroom accommodation. For example, in Belgium, we provide you furnished accommodation, single bedroom, at as low as 195 euros per month. 195 euros per month. You don't get even here in India. that's it, because one of the developer who was member of chamber like this, we appealed to him, and he is to real estate business. He readily agreed that I make 10 rooms available for India Welcome Center at this cost. It's a not even maintenance cost. Similarly, we have facilities in Japan, in Taiwan, in Korea, in Singapore, in, of course, at 3 locations in China. So please make use of this if you are looking for opportunities to do business outside India. So there are great opportunities. I think I'm part of the chamber. When please feel free to communicate with me. I'll be more than happy to have one-to-one detailed dialogue later on. I thought, let me give a glimpse what is potential to do together, and through chamber, let's take it forward. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Jagdare. Very, very important, useful, and energetic information you have given today. And I'm sure that, you know, members of the chamber, as well as, you know, the startups, SMEs, rather those are looking to support manufacturing industry. Particularly, they have idea, they have a technology, they can use our platform to connect to the SMEs.
Just one sec before, since you said, one sec, sir. We also have set up what is called CSSI Center, Center for Invention, Innovation and Incubation.
Okay.
So these centers are very high-end engineering design centers. We have softwares worth even 12 crore rupees, and they are commercial softwares, and these are available for SMEs. We have in Bombay, two in Pune, in Satara, but we are setting up at many locations. So these are available. So if you want to have a design software, access to design software, you want to do virtual design, virtual prototyping, virtual testing, then physical prototyping, 3D printing, metal printing, robotic welding, all these facilities are very high-end facilities are there at the centers. You are most welcome to make use of this facility.
Perfect. This is a rather, you know, very interesting support. Friends, you know, this is a very interesting and, you know, useful for you. Since you know, a lot of SMEs and a lot of, you know, the startups are having idea, you know, technological idea, but how to go for commercialization while connecting SME sector, that is the most important. So therefore, your science technology park, our chamber, our SME technology council can work together and can explore. And of course, you know, AWS is there to provide you a platform, the technological platform where you can establish, you can promote. So Harshad ji, you know, we have observed last 2 months that, and we have taken some, you know, ideas and, you know, information from the you know, particularly from SME manufacturing industry, how they have utilized the technology or digitalization during the pandemic. So we have observed that so many manufacturing industry, without going factory, they can't produce. Without you know, sitting in a factory, they can't, you know, look at the quality of the product. And mostly the people, those are attending business or, you know, manufacturing unit, they have to focus more on the productivity. So ultimately, the technology is the most important aspect. The person sitting here, he is watching his factory in Rajkot. He is giving orders, he is giving, you know, information. He's operating some machine sitting in Mumbai. So that much advanced technology developed in India and other country, where you're sitting in your room, you can operate your machine. Some chemical industries, they have their manufacturing unit in Ankleshwar and, you know, Chipluna or other places. The person sitting in Mumbai, he is giving the formulation ideas and formulation directions. What to be done, how to be done, and he's sitting here in a computer, he's giving. So that much development happened. So one message came from the member who is watching now Facebook, who is watching our SME TV platform, he's watching our video cast platform also. Around 600 people are watching currently. One member, the delegate is mentioning that many SMEs like me don't know how to use services of AWS. Do you provide a training or onboarding process to the customers? Those are needy customers, or those are looking for a technology?
And oh, absolutely. Very valid question, Mr. Salunke. And we get this question very often from SMEs, right? Like I said, No, I don't know how to use this. Can you tell me how to use this, right? So what we've done is two steps, right? AWS provides building blocks, right? So if you are at a very early stage in the business where you don't want to even read about stuff, right? So you can use some of the solutions that I spoke about because they're out of the box solution. You start using them right away, right? At the same time, if you are at a differentiate stage, which is the large stage where you want to really differentiate your business from your other competitors, you want to differentiate your products, and you want to use some of the AWS services, then we actually have free trainings that we run. Okay, people can just go sign up. There is no cost of those trainings. If you want to use any of, let's say, our data and analytics, for example, right? Or you want to use, like you said, in a manufacturing plant, let me give an example. One of the companies is actually using computer vision to see defects in the assembly line, right? So you don't have to someone person looking at it manually. They can take an image and see if there is a defect in the product, right? So those kind of things, you can look at our trainings which are available and enable the team, right? So that is perfectly possible. But if you are at an even early stage where you don't want to get it and all of that, you can use some of the ready-made solutions that I spoke around finance, HR, CRM and all.
Okay, good. Dr. Jagdale, since you have mentioned about a lot of support services, all these things, you know, the CISR, right? DSIR also, where the Dr. Marshallkar was there, the same place.
DSIR is under CSIR.
So what we can plan, you know, we have a lot of SMEs, those are looking for development of technology, looking for advanced technology, looking for development of the quality products, and those are having ideas, they want to go for commercialization. So we can create one module in this. So how we can take forward, that we'll discuss offline. But another point I would like to suggest, ask you the, as a question, that those startups are having ideas, but they face a problem while connecting with the needy companies, needy people, needy entrepreneurs. For that, we are there. SME Chamber will support that. So what is your observation? How they fail? Because see, we are not a Flipkart. We are not a big company like a Zomato or other thing. But small companies from the rural area, for example, let's say Satara, Kolhapur, Sangli, Solapur. These are the, you know, the small districts where small entrepreneur or any person taken a, you know, education, he has done some work and he wants to connect. So what is your observation where they have failed and where they are looking for support and services?
First thing is, number of incubators that you see in India, having 100, 200 incubators, it's a insignificantly low number. I would say the cities like Pune, we need to have at least 50 incubators. Bombay would need another 200 incubators, but there are hardly any. So there is always limitation of funding. Government of India through Niti Aayog, MeitY, DST, DBT, even MSME, agriculture, we have programmed to support incubators, but always funds are very limited. Unfortunately, even at government level, there's not very aggressive support to set up incubators, and any amount of funding is also limited. My request to we are doing our bit because we ourselves have created some additional funding. But my request to you that if through Chamber, if we ourselves create a fund, some of our well-to-do, say SMEs, we request them that, okay, we from SME Chamber of India creates a venture fund.
Okay.
We create venture fund and we don't ask for donations from our members. No, we ask for investment. Okay. You give us 1 lakh rupees per year.
Okay.
I'm not talking about how many members we have. There are thousands of SMEs, and if out of say 3.5 crore SMEs in India, even if 1 crore SMEs or even 50 lakh SMEs decide to contribute 1 lakh rupees per year, See the amount of money that we have.
Yes.
So huge amount. And that we go as an investment from them, and they become LPs. They become our limited liability partners, investors. And suppose somebody, some SME wants, say, 1 crore rupees. So maybe 10 companies together, they contribute 1 crore rupees. So risk is shared. Believe me, through our experience, return on equity that we have given money to startups is minimum 8 times in 3 years, 800%. And highest we have got is 137 times in 3 years. So that's a trust we need to have. If you give a freedom and trust them, and what they need is mentoring. I would say more than money is a right mentoring at right time. Guiding them properly makes them a success, better chance of increase the chance of success. So that's lacking. I think through chamber we should take that.
Sure, we'll pick up.
Yeah, we'll do that.
Yeah, definitely we'll take up, and you know, we can
virtually from a remote area, we are available for virtual mentoring. We are willing to talk to them. I don't mind dedicated, say, 1 hour every week. For our chamber members, if they want to ask anything, every week 1 hour, our experts will be there to guide them.
So let's finalize our schedule for our next 1 month, and let us explore this idea. This is very good support and very good platform. So Harshadji, you know, another very interesting subject come up now. How do AWS can provide a specific package for SMEs? Particularly the smart business solutions, means a special discount or special packages there, or any other, you know, depend on the uses. How you do that? Is there any system there?
Absolutely. Like I mentioned, Mr. Salunke, right? For some of the packages like Zoho and Grey HR, you can scan the QR code and you can get discounts right away, right? These are specifically meant for SME Chamber of India customers, right? And they can get that QR code through your team. So there are packages available to that extent. For rest of the products also, there are very good entry level packages where you don't even have to spend a lot of money, right, to get started. Okay. So this is on the pre-built solutions that are also available. Now, if you are also looking at AWS services, right? Okay. Our services, if you say that I want to build something on my own using the AWS services, then we do have, help customers with proof of concepts so that they want to run some experiments, try out things, right? So those are the things that we also take care. You can reach out to digitalsuit@amazon.com, anyone, and we will be more than happy to help them out.
Okay, good. So let us take forward now. This is a rather, good start, good, information. This is a very interesting session. Dr. Jagdale, how you observe that particularly failed startups or failed SMEs, those are, into capital goods manufacturing or, developing or research segment, where, particularly the knowledge based industry, particularly in a SME sector, they are facing a lot of problem while connectivize, while commercialization, and mostly the branding and marketing. So what is the message for this kind of, the SMEs or startups where they can use the new or unique idea?
I just give you just two examples, live examples. There's one company based out of Bangalore, which was into their developer platform for financial services. And I won't name one of the big company in India. We thought they're the right people to acquire them. This was one of the startups. And we requested this company to acquire for, we negotiated for about 36 crore rupees. The valuation is quite high, but we thought to acquire for 36 crore. They came down to only 9.5 crore. We thought it's not worth it. What we did was, we shifted this company to Silicon Valley within an incubator called Trivium, accelerator called Trivium in San Jose. They are friends, and we use their offices. by shifting the same company which was based in India to Silicon Valley, it became a US company. And believe me, this company was acquired for $136 million. By the same company having their office in US. Another example is Paytm. Paytm founder, you know that Paytm is now a Chinese company. Paytm was born in India, one of our startup. We tried a lot. Paytm founder struggled a lot to raise money, but nobody was even willing to put in even 1 crore rupees. By connecting to Jack Ma, the Paytm got so much of money. Because, so trust factor, I think we need to build a trust within the investors. And that's what we support, we do. So we have an accelerator program, we get VCs on board, we convince them. And so we have a lot of examples of acquisition, merger, and investment. So that's how we try to connect. It's not very easy. It's a very difficult task. Regarding the failure is concerned, I'm very happy when companies come to me. I first ask them, have you done the business before? Very shy. If they have done a business and failed, they are very shy. I say, don't be shy of failure. In this country, failure is not rewarded. We are here to reward the failure because they have experience. Many times the companies which have failed and they come as a startup, they still have a fire in the belly to start their own venture. The first word, my first criteria to select them because they are still have the passion to do it. So failure needs to be rewarded. I think that's again, so we have to tell our SMEs, don't be afraid of failure.
Okay, good. So thank you very much, Dr. Saab, and thank you, Harshad, very well played by, you know, particularly for the SME perspective. Friends, you know, this is a platform where you can share your thoughts, your ideas, your details of the product and services. And I'm very happy to announce that today that next month we are bringing a platform where you will register as a manufacturer or exporter, contract manufacturer exporter, and we are going to take responsibility for marketing your product in the market, in the world market.
Wonderful.
So you just keep attention to your product, productivity, quality, and competitiveness. SME Chamber of India will take guarantee for that your production, your promotion of your product in the international market. So with these words, I'm thankful to AWS. Thank you, Dr. Sam. And it is a pleasure that, you know, we have to promote market and brand SME sector. And let's have a chat again on offline. And thank you all the, you know, participants, those are attended and those are going to watch this our recording. I suggest share your product details, share your ideas, and share your issues and problems where we can guide you to resolve that. Thank you very much. Good.
Good. Thanks for organizing this event. Very good.
Thank you. Thank you.